Greetings and welcome to Tesla Fan Insight. Today's talk focuses on a concept called riffling. The problem that it addresses is the fact that currently with the S and X and with the new Model 3 coming out, there's a real challenge when it comes to the number of supercharger stations, particularly in high traffic areas at peak times. Bonjour, wie geht's? Wie steht's noch immer aus Zweibeinen? Strasvice. Guten Tag. Maslumcha, Maslumek. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. I've been intrigued by sort of bottlenecks that are associated with Tesla ownership. And one of them that's been fascinating for me to watch how it developed and how it's being addressed is the problem of how many supercharger stations are there and where they're located and how they handle the routine traffic. So because I'm in the United States, one of the main focal points of my attention to see how Tesla handles problems is the supercharger station at a place called Harris Ranch, which is about midpoint between San Francisco and Los Angeles. Elon Musk explained that one of the challenges that he's having with that location is the fact that if it's not Friday night or Sunday night, they have plenty of space and vehicles are able to come and go relatively easily for the full charge of 1 hour. As is the case in California and other locations around the world, when it comes to peak nights like Fridays or Sunday nights, Tesla's experiencing huge demand that kind of spikes. And so the issue is, how do you address this and how do you deal with this, particularly if you're a user of those facilities? One of the answers that popped up over the last week is something called riffling. And what riffling means is that there's someone that was driving a P190D and they were able to get as much as 561 miles in the vehicle before they ran out of charge. Now, if we look at this, you know, randomly, in theory, one could have gone from Los Angeles to San Francisco and back and almost not refilled. And so I thought this is an interesting sort of development that's worth attention. It turns out that what riffling is about is that this vehicle was doing 24 miles an hour, and their strategy was see how far we can go with this vehicle. But we're trying to find the exact speed that gives us the optimal distance, hence the term riffling. I was fascinated by this because as a commuter, one of the things I noticed sort of in the San Francisco Bay Area is there's a very intense rush hour between, let's say, 3:30 and about 7:30 p.m. if you leave before that or primarily leave after that. In that 8:30 zone, you can do a 30-mile trip from, let's say, Palo Alto to San Francisco in about 30 minutes, 35 minutes at 70 miles an hour. If you try to go at peak rush hour, the same trip will actually take you 2 to 3 hours because there are so many cars trying to make the trip all at the same time. So what this has to do with riffling is the fact that, in theory, you have the right to jump in your car and do 90 miles an hour trying to go from Los Angeles to San Francisco or vice versa. The problem you have is when you run at those high speeds, you tend to burn through your allocation of electric in the vehicle faster. So another option you have is to lower the speed, because as you lower the speed, you get more range. So the real question is, you know, do you want to do, I believe your minimum allowed on California freeways is 50 miles an hour. So in theory, if you ran at 50 miles an hour instead of the standard 70 miles an hour in the slow lane, would you then be able to perhaps skip the supercharger station at Harris Ranch and get to a station 50 to 100 miles further up where there's more population density, etc.? The reason to consider doing this is if there's a 3 hour wait at the supercharger station, it may be in your best interest. So you sort of have a choice. go real fast, end up in a 3-hour line to get your car recharged, or go slower, so you're now moving slower along the road, but the benefit is you move on to a supercharger location that may have a shorter line that you can go to, or there may be more stations in the area that you're headed to than in the middle of the state, where there's very little out there except for that one station. So I think this riffling concept is interesting. I'm actually looking forward to a series of owners sort of posting what their average speed was in the car to determine, you know, what ideal speed is relative to best distance in this situation. Another sidebar note on this is when Elon Musk learned about this new riffling record in the Model S, he pointed out that the car can actually go 601 miles in that process, but you have to use the right tires. He just didn't happen to mention which tires they were. So it'll be interesting to see in the comment section what other users are finding in this regard. Look forward to your comments. Thank you once again for taking time out to watch and listen. I'm going to close out with some of the view here on the water at the Potomac River in Alexandria, Virginia. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Merci beaucoup. Max Gutschus. Au revoir. Le Hitraout. Hoda Hafez. Salam alaikum. And look forward to our next conversation, as well as your comments on this situation. Thank you again, and have a great day.